Ghost signs are old advertising signs painted on the sides of buildings. They're around us in towns and cities, lurking above windows, around the chimney pots, or nestled amongst the signage on our modern high streets. When you start to search for ghost signs, you notice them everywhere. Large murals of commerce waiting to be found. Ghost signs in Great Yarmouth have been devised into a walking trail for everyone to be inspired by and imagine the people and stories that once occupied the town. Whoever painted these ghost signs probably wouldn't have imagined that we'd be out here making a documentary about them. They weren't intended for a 21st century consumer navigating with Google Maps, looking for fast food and fast fashion. Through these ghost signs, we're going to look deeper at the high street of Great Yarmouth. At a time when most houses maybe had a toilet outside, the Slipper Baths was a 1930s bathhouse that catered for the whole population with a hot bath. Inside, there were 12 cubicles, separated into male and female sections, but you were only allowed 20 minutes for your bath. And if you overstayed your welcome, the attendants would be hastily knocking on your door. And for an extra luxurious experience, in the 1960s, they installed a Brill Cream vending machine. Ghost signs stand in stark contrast to 21st century high-tech targeted adverts of today. Instead, ghost signs whisper themselves to anyone who is tempted to look closely. Ghost signs were originally made using oil-based house paints, and some of this paint originally contained lead, meaning it really strongly adhered to the masonry. And as this was painted over and over, it helped preserve that original layer of paint, and that some of the ghost signs that we see today were made using that paint. This used to be one of East Anglia's biggest department stores. And you can see just around the top, the A emblem still remains, even though there was a fire here in 1919. The fire was so big, it required soldiers and a steam float to come down this high street and actually sort it all out. What's interesting about Arnold's, it's very easy to miss. Essentially, you've got all the big brands underneath at the bottom. And the A's, unless you were looking up and paying attention, it's quite easy to miss these A's. And then just above them, there's this sculpted head. I'm not sure whether this is the sort of the emblem, the signifier of Arnold's. Maybe that's Arnold himself, I'm not quite sure. But you can see evidence of this kind of frilly, flamboyant experience inside. There is always a degree of mystery around these signs, helped by the fact that they are sometimes hard to read. The Great Yarmouth General Hospital was opened thanks to voluntary contributions from local people. You can't see the hospital now, but the ghost sign still remains that says doctors parking only, which is gradually beginning to erode due to wind erosion, the paints flaying, so it might not be around for much longer. I guess the question now is whether you can restore it and it might be someone's job to sort of paint the letters white, or do you sort of let it naturally erode and just take its sort of natural course? I think it's sort of quite beautiful as it is. Great Yarmouth's ghost signs are nostalgic and wholesome, harking back to a high street abundant with unique, independent retailers. The Singer Manufacturing Company. It moved here in 1892, and you can just imagine these were all the rage in Great Yarmouth at the time. So this Singer's sign, interestingly, this was actually discovered during renovation works. So for a long time, we didn't realize it's here. So thanks to renovations, we can actually uncover the ghost signs that we didn't even know existed. This one's wearing away quite a bit at the moment. And the S is cut off a little bit. But you can still imagine this probably would have been gold or yellow lettering. So yeah, this is one of my favourites, this one.
These street paintings seem to erode at a glacial pace. But they are, of course, semi-permanent, subject to the erosion of sea wind or developers keen to erect a glossy new facade.
The Municipal School of Art. Built in 1912 by John W. Cockrell, who also built the local old fire station.
And you can see this beautiful Art Deco lettering was actually covered up by white paint until the late 20th century, when it was sort of renovated into local housing. It was during the Second World War that this building was used for a civil defence report centre. And actually, the local area is super interesting because it's what's called the rope walk, where they would lay out these strands of twine and then wrap them into rope for the fishermen to use.
Ghost signs are not limited to Great Yarmouth. All you need to do is look up and search for typographic relics that gracefully puncture the brickwork.
One thing you notice when you keep looking up on buildings is how many sort of seagulls are stood on them and how poop covered they are. I particularly like the Municipal School of Art ghost sign. There are many of quality on the trail that I'd recommend checking out, but I could just imagine myself as a young adult going off to art school, and it wasn't too dissimilar to a building such as this. So I do feel quite nostalgic. I romanticise the past. So I do enjoy this one.
The real spooky story is that these ghost signs might one day peel, flake or vanish. They demand to be looked at and celebrated.